I want to go ahead and show you where you can build agents. So you have to go here, right? You go to agents, and I've configured three specific deep research agents. So I called it the search planner, which basically plans the search for me. This is based on this planner orchestrator worker architecture. And these are just my sub agents that I've created. I should be able to see all the agents right here. So under my .cloud agents folder, I have search orchestrator, I have the search planner and search summarizer. So if you take a look, here's how it's configured. Basically, these are the system prompts along with the instructions of how the sub-agent should perform, along with also the tools that the agent has access to. So these tools are already configured here with Claude Code, and this agent can utilize those tools. You'll also need to provide a description, which is something you can do when you're creating and configuring your sub-agent. So I've created three of them. Search Planner is the other one. So this one is a little bit more detailed, but basically this is one of the agents or sub-agents that I use to ensure that the deep research agent is doing a bit of planning before executing the web searches. So the planner plans the web searches, the orchestrator executes the searches, and then I have a search summarizer, which summarizes the results from the search orchestrator, whoever I want in whatever format. So if you look at this one here, this is the format that I'm going for with the sources and so on. The way how I can use these sub-agents, I can literally go to Claude Code here and just ask it to use the different sub agents. I will need to command it to actually go and use those, or Claude Code can decide to use your sub agents by itself. One better way that's more reliable that I've tested here is the use of the slash commands. So basically what I've done is I've created a slash command called deep research. Right here, I'm just going to show you deep research, and basically it's just another MD file. So if we look at the MD file, what it is, here are your instructions for the provided query arguments, which is just basically, I'm going to say, what are the latest news from Claude Code in July 2025? So these are more complex searches, and for those I want to use deep research, it's basically something that I fully customized. So it's actually doing what I want. So here I tell it use the search planner agent to break down the query into specific search subtasks. Use the search orchestrator agent to search for the subtasks. Return the web search results. Use the search summarizer agent to summarize the search results. Then return the output of the search summarizer sub agent. Don't run any other additional commands or instructions, and that's pretty much it. So this allows me to chain all of these sub agents, and especially for this, I actually want a specific flow. And if I want to do any changes within those flows, I'll just specify it here. So these are just the high level instructions. So once I have it like this, then now I can go ahead and I can just create this deep research task. So I'll just go ahead and search for what are the latest news from Claude Code in July 2025. So first it's going to trigger the search planner, right? And this is cool because this search planner, I've actually configured it to have a bash tool, which can essentially provide the date. And this is really important for when planning the searches, because if you see in this query, I have latest news, which means I want the latest information, which means that the date is really important for the agent to have as part of the context. So that's done by this particular sub-agent. All right, so the plan is done. Now it's doing the orchestrator. By the way, the orchestrator can also have a search worker. So a search worker basically do the web search itself. And so the search orchestrator will work with the search worker to do that. But because Claude Code has a built-in tool called web search, I can just utilize that within the search orchestrator. But that's the next step. The next step is to actually use a custom search API. This has nothing to do with code, but you can imagine that maybe you want the latest documentation, the latest release logs, all of that stuff, or documentation or anything that you want to pull, and you want to do some deeper research on that, or you want to do deep research on any topic like that, then you can essentially use something like this. All right, so it's done with the search orchestrator. And then this is the final step, which is the search summarizer. So you can see for each sub-agent how much tokens have been used and how much time it took. This is the one that's going to take the longest, obviously. All right, so it looks like we have the web search results here. So based on my comprehensive research, here are the key cloud developments from July 2025. So we have general availability launch. Now we have major features added, right? MCP supported with OAuth 2.0, that was recent as well. And now we have custom commands, sub-agents, and slash commands. Sub-agents is literally what I'm using here. And then we have these extensions as well. So we have a lot of different changes. And notice that it's referencing the date. So here on Tropic Titan usage limits without prior notice, there was a lot of complaints about that affecting heavy users on the 200 per month max plan. And that's important context for me, for people that want to upgrade as well, or for people that are already upgraded. And so generally positive with strong performance comparisons and active community resources. And then final summary, just a final summary. Notice that this doesn't include the sources, which I wanted also as part of the summary that the deep research agent was sending me back. And that's because I don't have a lot of control over that built-in web search tool. The next step for me is to actually include my own web search tool, which I can specify the date ranges searches and also get the source links for those search results. If you want to see a full breakdown of how I've configured this and how I built this, let me know in the comments. And if there's enough interest, I'll probably do a video and post it here on YouTube and so on. I'll see you all in the next one.